something's happening. It was the only time gun violence was brought up in the two-hour debate.
I feel that the gun-free zones, and, you know, when you say that, that's target practice for the sickos and for the mentally ill. That's target. They look around for gun-free zones.
That's the kind of attitude people hear are trying to change.
It just feels like we've become numb to this level of violence in our country, and we are just average people out here saying no more, we're done.
But the voices outside of last night's debate aren't the only ones speaking up about this.
I think gun-free zones are a catastrophe. They're a feeding frenzy for sick people.
One Colorado Springs gun shop owner who's been here more than three decades calls Donald Trump's statement the truth.
Look at the Aurora Theater case. I mean, there's a gun-free zone. It's very easy to assault people that are in places that they can't be armed.
Paul Paradis is a certified NRA instructor and teaches monthly gun safety classes.
A lot of bit of paperwork that's created at a gun sale and the background checks and everything hasn't stopped one single criminal from getting a gun or committing a crime.
But on the other side, people look to our state as the example for the rest of the country.
I'd like to see the nation take on some of the sensible gun control that we have here in Colorado. Universal background checks, limits on the size of magazines.
Are we going to lock up the criminals, or are we just going to create more paperwork? You decide.
In Colorado Springs, Eric Fink, KRDO News Channel 13.
Eric Fink, not to be confused with Donald Trump. Very different people there. Last night's debate went a little more than 2 hours. Gun violence was talked about for just 90 seconds.
Well, new video out tonight from that bike.